Welcome back to Select Start, and my name is Jay.
And I'm Dio, and we just got the Nintendo Switch.
And we're playing Zelda Breath of the Wild. I'm a huge Zelda fan.
Not only that, I feel that the Switch has done its job. It's delivered on what it's promised in terms of portability, in terms of gameplay, in terms of, you know, being that hybrid machine that it was hyped to be.
That's right. Like, but you guys heard my opinions on the game, on the system, actually. And I was kind of biased, but now I'm totally excited. I love the quality of the system.
It's a real big success for Nintendo, as far as I'm concerned.
Me too.
And one of the main reasons is, of course, this game.
Lots of potential. Lots of potential.
This Zelda is just fantastic. It's it's an open world game, and there's a lot of them out there. You know, everyone makes the comparisons to, you know, Far Cry and Assassin's Creed. Most recently, Horizon Zero Dawn, another great game. For the PS4, that's open world. That's also getting rave reviews, and one that I wholeheartedly agree with. I have that game. Maybe one day we'll play it for the channel. But this is a different kind of open world that's just as fun and scratches an old itch.
Open your eyes, Link.
So, I mean, if you think about it, it's the first Zelda game since the original that just drops you into the story.
Yep. Yeah. And go adventuring. And that was Miyamoto's goal.
Open your eyes.
And for the first time, I think there's some voice acting.
Yeah.
Wake up, Link.
Yeah. Box of briefs.
Hillion boxer briefs.
But this is it. This is all the story you get at the beginning. You just wake up in a shrine and you it's time to go. And, you know, some people may not necessarily be fans of the more cartoony style.
Yeah.
They would have maybe preferred something a little bit more along the lines of, let's say, Twilight Princess. Mm-hmm. As far as, like, I don't want to say graphics or shading. Like, that's the wrong sort of terminology. But as far as, like, art style goes,
in my opinion, there's no argument here because it looks great.
It does. And you know what? This is one of the things that I tell people when they critique the art style. It makes it more timeless. Like, you don't feel that any of the Zelda games have really aged poorly. Except for maybe Ocarina of Time, but that's, you know, a whole different story because, let's be honest, I call that, like, the evolution of, like, 3D gaming.
Mm-hmm.
Like, N64 era, early N64 era, and early PS2 era, when they were first trying to, like, understand how to make 3D graphics work,
They
didn't really hold up too well. But since then, like, all of these Nintendo games have really got, like, a timeless quality to them. You could go back and play Wind Waker anytime, and it feels just as, you know, vibrant.
And for new gamers out there, and this will be their first Zelda game, I think this will be an amazing experience for, like, young kids that are, like, 10 to 13 years old. Like, I was 10 years old the first time I played Zelda.
And it's amazing. This is the thing. The fact that it's, like, constantly, like, making you equip items, inventory, this and that, it makes it a little bit more like the comparisons have been made to Skyrim already. you know what I mean? Like, go out, adventure, find loot, or Dark Souls-y, because Dark Souls, it's the type of game where you're constantly finding new weapons and new items.
And fighting and fighting and fighting constantly.
So it's more open in terms of weaponry and gameplay and style. Some people have even compared it to Metal Gear because there's sneaking parts where you can, like, try to, like, sneak up on the bad guys and get insta kills while they're sleeping.
So what's happening here? You equipped everything that you found in the chest, the Sheikah slate, open the door.
Yeah.
I have your sleeping chamber, and you're all groggy. It's like, man, I have a hangover. What do you want?
Link, you are the light. Our light. That must shine upon Hyrule once again. Now go.
Yeah.
Do you think that's Zelda's voice?
Oh, it has to be. And by the way, I inverted the jump controls because it's just more natural, I find, to have jump be the bottom button rather than the top one. That's an option you have to actually, like, go into the menu and do. I've also turned off the motion controls. Not that they're bad, but with motion controls activated, if you're at... I tend to get excited when I play. Mm-hmm. And, like you know, in driving games, sometimes you, like, reflexively turn your hands.
Yeah.
As if it's a real, real thing. So, I get animated a lot. So, when I'm trying to, like, carefully aim with my thumbs and I accidentally move my hand, it throws the aim off a little bit. But if you're using it actually the way it's intended with the motion controls, it's really smooth.
Cool. So... go talk to that creepy old man. You got a tree branch. Smoke it.
Use your weapon.
Yeah. Okay, it's a weapon. So you're gonna pick up some mushrooms, I guess, for some cooking.
That's the cool thing about the game too. The inventory is almost infinite, meaning, if you're picking up items and stuff, you always have room in your inventory for more. It's only weapons and big objects like shields and bows that it starts to become a problem with in terms of spacing. Like, what do you want to keep? What do you want to throw away?
Cool.
So that's why at the beginning I'm just picking up everything.
That's it. Are you having a...
and the game trying to teach you there's physics. A little bit of time. So this game is really awesome. Like, in terms of exploration, it rewards it in every conceivable way.
The cool thing I'm seeing here is you could climb anywhere.
Oh, the sense of movement in this game. You're never stuck. Never stuck.
Unless you run out of stamina.
Stamina. Come on, old man. Who are you? Where are we? Answer a question with a question. That is fair enough. As I cannot imagine our meeting to be a simple coincidence, I shall tell you. This is the Great Plateau. According to legend, it is the birthplace of the entire kingdom of Hyrule. Do you like my lantern stick? I light the way. Sat panda in a state of decay. This is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
As a weapon. Lock on. So it's pretty straightforward, at least at the beginning. You know, it sort of funnels you in a certain direction, but...
yeah, chop some wood.
So, the trick...
what's on top of that pyre where that lake is?
Put it away so I could not have it on fire anymore.
Yep. Good old N64 way. It's like a Deku stick. This time they're actually calling it a tree branch.
Yeah, seriously. Oh, What's going on?
Head for the point marked on the map in your Sheikah slate.
Okie dokie.
You have a new objective.
Sorry. Come on. Shiny objects draw my attention. Huh? Oh, take this, eat stick. Yeah. So that's what makes it fun. The sense of adventure, like in terms of, you know, you never know what's around the next corner, is always fun.
It looks amazing. Especially the old ruins.
And you know what? People will say and complain that, oh, it's, how should I put it? What's the word I'm looking for? It's not 1080p. It's not true high def. Because man, when it's in the portable mode, it's 720p. When it's in the non-portable mode, meaning in the dock and playing on the TV like we're doing right now, I believe I heard it gets upscaled to 900.
Yeah. But at this point, where we're at, the stage where games are at, okay, you're not going to go any further right now. Okay? And saying like, graphics aren't great. No. You know what? These are great. It looks amazing. It's all about the gameplay.
Oh, yeah. 100%. If the gameplay is there, I don't care what it looks like.
Seriously, we play all sorts of games. We play games like Undertale, and we love that game. Right?
I'm trying to sneak up on this guy. Yeah. Damn it! Ah, shit! I forgot to equip something.
You're waving at him? Here, take that tree branch. Axe him.
Oh, you throw a rock at me? Who do you think you are?
Get that chest.
That's just it. Like, even the enemies, if they lose their weapon, they try to grab it back if you don't pick it up. They'll use their environment just like you use yours.
You got some Hylian trousers.
Look, small little details. Like, you could eventually, you start crafting your own armors. There's such a sense of progression, I guess, in this game.
Mm-hmm.
The same kind of, like, instant gratification for doing something, whether it's big or something small, is there. Just like there was, like, in Skyrim, where you would go out and get rewarded for like a quest or doing something like right away, or you would find a new piece of armor and you'd get excited. It's that sense of discovery is everywhere in this game.
Oh, it's rolling boulder time. They're right there, the other way. Oh. There you go.
Yeah, insta-kill.
I love the colors.
Oh, the game is gorgeous. They've done an amazing job.
And how long has it been since you played a Zelda game? What was the last game?
Twilight Princess was the last one that I could truly say I played.
But she didn't finish. She didn't complete it.
No.
Man, you're missing out. It was a great game. Amazing. Skyward Sword, in my opinion, was a very, very good game. It's just emotion controls, as you you keep saying, you know, it's annoying. But, yeah, I'm excited to see what this has to offer as in adventures and boss battles and dungeons and stuff like that.
Yeah, I don't necessarily like using the bow, but that's because I'm bad with it right now. Which is why I try to, like, run up on these guys if I can.
For weapons and bows and stuff like that, does that level up? Like, one-handed weapons and two-handed?
No, there's no leveling up. It's just the items themselves. Like, some are better than others. And you got an instant, like, zoom, which is always cool.
That's like some Thundercats shit. That's a Eye of Thundera.
Sheikah Slit, give me sight beyond sight. Gonna try to sneak up on this guy. And some people have complained that the HUD is a little too messy. No, and I understand that. Like, if you notice next to the mini-map,
yeah,
the purple is how much noise I'm making, and right above that is the temperature gauge.
That's fine.
Like, if you're, yeah, sword.
And I don't find it to be a lot.
No, but I understand, like, if you want to fully immerse yourself, you could turn it off, you know what I mean? And it would just become, like, a thing of beauty.
However, I think it's a thing of beauty already. People are complaining too much. Sometimes you just gotta take things the way they are.
Mm-hmm.
Go, Sheikah Slate. I find that's so cool. You know, you have to put the Sheikah Slate in there. It opens the door, or it's an upgrade. It's pretty cool.
So this is their version, I guess, of the Far Cry Towers. You know what I mean? Or the Assassin's Creed, like, climb the tall point to, like, reveal stuff on the map, that trope. This is how Nintendo does theirs. Go ahead and climb that thing. Pretty awesome. And you know what? I find it sort of interesting story-wise that the Sheikah,
mm-hmm,
who have built all this technology, is exactly that. It's technology. It's, you know what I mean? Like, when you see it saying, like, authenticating, like, it feels more like it's future tech that we just don't understand, and people called it magic.
Yeah. I kind of like it. You know, the thing is, you know, what else can you put into a Zelda game? How can you make it new and different? These guys achieved that by taking what was so old and making something new out of it.
You have been asleep for the past 100 years.
Oh, damn! Rip Van Winkle!
The beast. When the beast regains its true power, this world will face its end.
Ah, good old pig face! Ganon! That's awesome! That's intimidating. That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
You must hurry, Link.
Sure, I'll face that with my three heart pieces.
Yeah, like you said, there's some people who just went straight to that.
Oh, it is crazy out there. People are already speedrunning this game. I think I heard last it was down to like just under 51 minutes.
That's insane. That's sick.
Because everywhere you see, you could go. Everywhere. That's what's insane about this.
I don't know. In my opinion, like, speedrunners, like, right off the bat, like, on a new game, I think you're just, like, spoiling the shit out of the game.
Here's the thing, though. I gotta get used to pressing the A button to confirm, but Nintendo's A. I'm so used to the PlayStation style where it's, like, you know what I mean?
And you inverted the jump button.
Yeah. I'm not taking no chances. Last thing I want is to,
fall down? Get hurt?
Fall down too far, yeah. There we go. Hup. Hup. There we go.
Just stand on the top and just scream. I fought in your general direction.
What's going on?
Stupid troll.
I heard a voice. Light the way. That is Calamity Ganon. 100 years ago, that vile entity brought the kingdom of Hyrule to ruin. So we went to sleep and Ganon took over. Hyrule Castle's managed to contain the evil, but just barely. Oh, yeah. Don't worry, old man. I will save the castle. All steep cliffs with no way down. If we were to try a jump, well, no death would be more certain or more foolish. Hmm. Hand it over. Hmm. He wants the treasure. Hmm. So, like it said, this is your adventurer's log, so it keeps track of your missions, just like it would for any adventure game,
mm-hmm.
Which is always a plus.
And how is the rumble feature on the Joy-Cons? Do you like it?
It's very subtle when it needs to be. I think it's really well done. Mm-hmm. It really is. The shrines. Done and done. To the shrines. Sneak up on this guy.
Oh, is he going to see you? Yeah,
shit. Damn it! Burr, 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 burr. You want to go? You want to go? Uh-oh. No!
You have a hard time equipping stuff, I see.
Come here, you. Smash you in the face. Little camps that you can take out. Instant rewards.
And what is that skull chest up there?
It's a reward. You cleared out the goblins, you get a reward.
That's awesome.
Every inch of this game is littered with something to do.
Ooh, traveler's sword.
It's so much fun in terms of exploration and reward.
Did you encounter the Lost Woods yet?
The Lost Woods?
Yeah. Is there any Lost Woods in here? Like,
oh,
a forest area?
We have gotten that far. Or at least I haven't seen any yet, but we just started playing, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know just what's beyond the horizon.
Well, we saw Death Mountain from the peak.
The volcano? Yeah, I guess that would be Death Mountain. That would make sense. Serving energy. This is the only downside that I find. Like, I like the stamina system isn't bad, except when you're swimming.
It goes fast, eh?
I feel that him drowning is not a plus. Him being able to drown. Like, I understand him being able to swim fast, but
wait until you get the Zora flippers, bro.
Probably. You know what? I wouldn't be surprised.
Oman O Shrine.
Password confirmed.
Choo 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 choo.
Space battle.
Yeah! And we'll see what's in the shrine next time on Select Start. What do you think, Jay?
Perfect timing.